Yes, once again, it's time for another episode of The Living Word. An episode that begins with praise and ends with prayer. And echoing the spirit of praise is the Salvation Army Band playing the familiar and majestic hymn, Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven, to his feet thy tribute bring. Was music by the Salvation Army Band. But now for another look at life, or perhaps I should say, another look at life and death.
Happens to be Mrs. Garland. I say you do have a good hand, don't you? But nothing but you.
Oh, he draws anything. He'll even draw you.
What a splendid compliment. I think I have 50 cents worth of your anything, Mr. Field. So long as you don't draw me as a child.
Oh, I have a bad habit of doing that sometimes. Would you mind turning your profile a little to the left, please?
Not at all.
Ambulance. Somebody must have got hurt.
Run along if you'd like to, Gordy.
Yeah, I guess I'd better.
He's a good boy. We're business partners. I draw, he sells. A little more to the left, please.
I hate silence. They always give me the feeling of death being just around the corner. My pop. I came up here for my newspaper to cover the art exhibit inside. You've seen it, I suppose.
Yes, I have.
Fine group of turners. The most extraordinary collection of the early works of Beauchamp. And a splendid arrangement of a group of seven. But what fascinated me most were the pictures by Beauchamp. What a strange man he must have been.
Yes, he was.
Don't tell me you knew him.
A bit more profile.
Well, now, this is exciting. So few people know anything about him at all. Don't tell me you studied him.
I did.
Now, Phil, would you mind giving me your recollections of him? I'd be glad to pay you for anything you can give me about that extraordinary character. I need a story for my column. Or am I stepping on your toes? What I mean by that is, he became so fabulously successful. Whereas you...
The sidewalk artist.
At least you look happy. And I'm sure he never was. Of course, he was famous. And what a wonderful touch he had with her. And then, suddenly, he vanished. The top of his profession, wealthy, with the world at his feet. He walked out of his studio one night, never to be seen again. Why? That's the story. Why?
Yes, it is odd, isn't it?
You say you knew him. Can you guess why?
You know what people say? They say he was giving a big party in his studio one night. All the usual party features. When, for no reason that anyone knows, threw down his brush and shouted, "I can't paint surfaces anymore." Then he walked out. So they say.
They say more than that. I know because I was at that party, although I didn't see him leave. They say he shouted, "I'm sick and tired. I won't paint any more portraits unless it's the face of God."
So they say.
I wonder if he's still alive. If he's ever found the face of God.
Well, he wasn't a very good man. He was a gambler.
They say he gave that up.
Drunk.
They say he stopped drinking.
It was never true to any woman.
Except for one. So they say.
More, yes.
I used to wonder about him. Supposing he went out to find God and never found him. That would be pretty awful, wouldn't it?
What's the trouble, Gordy?
Nothing. You finished with Miss Driver's sketch?
Just about.
Then I'll see if I can go and get us some new business. Have your likeness made. Only 50 cents. 50 cents for your likeness.
Gordy, come back here.
What?
Now, sit down here beside me. What's happened, Gordy?
There's a little girl. She's going in front of a truck. She isn't dead, but she could have been.
Well, as long as she's not dead.
But she could have been.
What's troubling you, son?
On the way back from the main gate, I kept thinking. Supposing it had been me. Supposing I had been killed. What is it like, Mr. Steele? What is it like to be dead?
Well, I asked me.
I thought you'd know.
I think Mr. Beauchamp is a little shy.
Beauchamp?
I meant Mr. Steele. What do you think it's like to be dead, Gordy?
I don't know. Except that you have to face God.
Does that frighten you?
Well, it did. And I saw what happened, it did. Now with Mr. Steele again, I'm not so frightened anymore.
What you did must be a very difficult thing, Mr. Beauchamp.
Perhaps. At first.
It's no use hiding any longer. You are André Beauchamp, aren't you? Why don't you give the boy the answer to his question? I know you have the answer.
What was your question, son?
I asked you what it was like to be dead.
Well, the answer is really quite simple. When we believe in God, and when we know His Son, Jesus, as our Savior, and the sins and wrongs of the past are forgiven, then to be dead is to be twice as much alive. When I walked out of that studio party, I died to the sin and meaninglessness of my past. My soul breathed a freshness such as I had never known. My friends, I was dead. But I had really entered into a new life. And for those who love God, Gordon, death must be something like that. The things we have now, we leave behind for a new life. With him. Forever. Death. To be dead is to be twice as much alive.
To be dead in Christ is to be twice as much alive. That's worth thinking about. Evidently, the Apostle John, writing in one of his epistles, had been thinking about it. This is the record, that God hath given to us eternal life, and this life is in his Son. He that hath the Son hath life, and he that hath not the Son of God hath not life. This is a great and wonderful truth, that in Christ there is eternal life. That brings to mind a song.
Who comes for me, the Savior said, to him I freely give eternal life, though he were dead, yet henceforth shall he
pray that everyone sharing this moment of prayer shall realize that thou didst send thy Son Jesus to be our Savior, so that we might not only have life, but that we might have it more abundantly. This we ask in and through the name of Jesus, thy Son and our Savior. Amen. Be sure and join us again when we will seek to learn more of the living Word and of him who is in very truth the living Word.